ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट फीचर ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग, दैट इज एब्स्ट्रैक्शन। इन द लास्ट टाइम वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द इनहेरिटेंस एंड पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म फीचर। नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट another feature of object oriented programming, that is abstraction. Okay, so what is the meaning of abstraction is, means if I take an example, suppose abstraction means hiding something. Okay, hiding something. So in the case of Java programming language, yeah, any programming language, abstraction means hiding the implementation detail. Okay, hiding the implementation detail. Hiding the implementation detail. Okay. Suppose in the real scenario, if I take an example, means suppose if you use any appliance, home appliance like refrigerator, air conditioner, so basically you just take the facility of that particular appliance. You need not to know the implementation detail of that particular appliance. So you can say that actually air conditioner and refrigerator is abstract for the user, means implementation detail is abstract for the user. Okay, means how it works actually. Now in order to understand the Java abstraction, I take an example. Okay, I take a case from which you can understand that why abstraction is required. So suppose there is a class, any class, suppose if I take a class math, suppose math is a class. Okay, and in this class there is a method, that is calculate method. Suppose there is a method, calculate method, integer calculate, and here it will take a integer number. And what this particular method will return, suppose it will return x multiplied by x. You can say that this calculate method is used to square a particular value. Okay, now this is a class, simple class mathematics. So if you create the object, if you create suppose three objects of this class, if you create three objects of this class, is feeling small ho gaya, that actually this is capital, in capital letter, math m1 equal to math constructor, math m2 is equal to new math, and suppose math m3 is equal to new math. Okay, and now there are three objects. First object is referred by m1, second object is referred by m2, and the third object is referred by m3. So if there are three objects are created in heap memory, the first one is referred by m1, second one is referred by m2, this is referred by m1, this is referred by m2, this is referred by m3. तो ईच ऑब्जेक्ट हैज इट्स ओन कॉपी ऑफ कैलकुलेट मेथड होगा, मीन्स शेयर करेंगे, एक्चुअली ईच ऑब्जेक्ट शेयर द सेम मेथड. ओके, इट्स मीन्स एम वन कैन एक्सेस कैलकुलेट मेथड in order to calculate the square value. M2 can also access the calculate method in order to access the square value of a particular integer value. And M3 also call the calculate method in order to find out the square of a particular number. Now, suppose the case is if M1 would like to calculate the cube of number. Okay, M1 would like to calculate the cube of a particular number with the help of same method calculate. M2 would like to find out the square of a particular number with the help of same method. And similarly, M3 would like to find out the suppose cube square and x plus x, suppose like this, means actually multiply by 2. Suppose there are three operations. So there are three objects, and if each objects would like to perform the same calculate method but in different way, methods is same, the method name is same but the definition part is different. So how can we achieve this? If all three objects would like to perform the different task with the help of same method calculate, aisa ho sakta hai? Nahi ho sakta hai. Ek method teen task ko perform karega nahi. However, there is a if you would like to make a separate class and inherits the math class, then that particular class can override the calculate methods. कर सकता है इस particular case के लिए, बस उस case में भी तीन objects हैं. Okay, see. So there is a solution. With the help of a calculate method, it is not possible because calculate method is shared by all three object in any case for this particular example. Because this particular method is shared by all objects. So one thing is, if there are three operations, so either you can create three separate method means you can achieve this by method overloading. Suppose if you achieve this by method overloading, basically there are three tasks which are required to perform. One is cube, the another one is square, and the third operation is 2x, return 2x. So if you overload the method, calculate method, suppose if you overload the calculate method, you can overload the calculate method. So if you overload the calculate method, so this is possible or not? Suppose in a class math, I just overload the method, means integer calculate integer x, it will return x multiplied by x. Another method, integer calculate integer x, and here return x multiplied x multiplied x. And in the third method, integer calculate integer x, it will return 2x. So there are three methods you need to define. Okay, and suppose if you create the three objects, math m1, one is referred by math m1, another one is referred by स्मॉल लेटर में हो जा रहा है, इसको कैपिटल लेटर में अज्यूम करके चलिए, मैथ एम वन मैथ एम टू. मैथ एम वन math m2, math m3. Now is it possible or not? M1 can perform, yeah, M1 can call the calculate first calculate method, M2 can call second calculate method, and M3 can call third calculate method. The task is achieved, but what is the problem here? Is there any problem?
Sir, it doesn't know which method to call.
Okay, it doesn't know which method to call. देखो ये this is a good question. And sorry, this is a good answer. It doesn't know which method is called because the signature is same. So this is the problem. The signature is same. How can you basically solve this problem? It means if you would like to
signature को double float कर देंगे.
सिग्नेचर को अगर आप डबल फ्लोट करोगे इफ यू चेंज द सिग्नेचर मीन्स हियर आपने कहते ऐसा करते हम डबल कर लेते हैं तो कुछ दिक्कत तो है नहीं जस्ट एंड जस्ट चेंज द सिग्नेचर कोई बात नहीं ठीक है वन सिग्नेचर इज डबल अनदर वन इज फ्लोट दिस इज इंटीजर एक्स तो हियर इफ दिस इज डबल तो आंसर विल बी इन डबल फॉर्मेट एंड हियर इन दिस केस आंसर विल बी float and here the answer will be in integer format then okay however in this case you can also pass the double value okay means yahan restriction khatam ho gaya ki integer value hi pass kar diye you can basically solve this problem by just changing the signature but in this case in the first calculate method either you can pass integer or as well as double because double can take the integer value okay and another way is ki aisa karte hain overloading ka concept hi khatam karte hain just change the name of method the first method is calculate square the second method is calculate cube and the third method is calculate multiply either we can change the signature or we can change the name of method okay so problem is solved but there is one more problem here is humne kya bola tha shuruaat mein ki m1 would like to only perform ya m1 would like to only know the square of a particular number ya integer number m2 can only perform ya can only find out the cube of a number and m3 can only find out the multiplication by 2 so in this case if you define three methods so three methods are copied ya three methods are shared by each object m1 m2 and m3 it means m1 can also call cube method m1 can also call multiply method tabhi problem ho gayi bhai m1 ko cube ki zarurat hi nahi hai to kyon zabardasti usko cube diye If M1 doesn't require cube, तो भाई अब ये होगा कि सर दे देते हैं क्या लॉस क्या है नहीं यूज करेगा मेथड रहने देते हैं ऐसा तो है नहीं कि नहीं यूज करेगा तो आप दे दोगे मेथड क्योंकि एक्चुअली ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग इज रिलेटेड टू द रियल वर्ल्ड एंटिटी ठीक है अब आपने क्लर्क बनाया और क्लर्क को दे दिया कि मैनेजर वाली मैथड तब तो क्लर्क मैथड वाला मैनेजर वाला मेथड्स को कॉल कर सकता है ना तो वो तो कर नहीं सकते आप ओके तो हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम मींस ईच ऑब्जेक्ट कैन ओनली कॉल ए यूनिक मेथड विद द हेल्प ऑफ मेथड ओवरलोडिंग इट इज नॉट अचीव्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ थ्री डिफरेंट मेथड इट इज आल्सो नॉट अचीव्ड कम टू द मेथड ओवरराइडिंग ठीक है मेथड ओवरराइडिंग में आके देखते हैं इन द केस ऑफ मेथड ओवरराइडिंग व्हाट यू नीड टू डू हियर क्या करना होगा इन द केस ऑफ मेथड ओवरराइडिंग See, suppose there is a class math. And there is a method integer calculate integer x return x multiplied x. Suppose this is a method. Just make another class, that is class math, suppose for cube, which extends math class, and now this math cube class override this method according to its own need. So if this override integer calculate integer x, and now it will return x multiplied x multiplied x. So if you would like to find out the square, then you need to create the object for this method. If you would like to perform the cube operation, you need to create the object of math cube. And now all math cube objects call the cube operation only. Similarly, for the multiply operation, you can create another class like this, math extends math multiply extends math class. And in this class, again integer calculate integer x, and here return 2 into x. So this is okay, because with the help of method overriding we can achieve this. Fine. Now, but there are three classes. This math override this method now. Here you can see that there is a math cube class, there is a math multiplication class. If there are other, if you would like to perform some another operation over the x, so you can create some more class. Fine. So here you can see that this is the main class, that is, you can call it as a base class, and all other class are derived class. So with the help of method overriding, you can achieve this. But here, in this example, this is okay. But suppose in place of math, suppose math is a general class and calculate is a method. Okay. Suppose in place of math, if we replace math with another example, another class, that is class bank. Suppose there is a bank class, okay, and in bank class there is a method integer get interest. So I just take another example, क्योंकि फिर हम आपको बताएंगे कि एब्स्ट्रैक्शन की जरूरत कहां पड़ेगी. दिस इज मेथड ओवरराइडिंग कांसेप्ट. एंड नाउ सपोज इफ आई टेक अनदर एग्जांपल लाइक क्लास बैंक, एंड देयर इज अ मेथड दैट वन इज इंटीजर गेट इंटरेस्ट. Okay, it will return some value integer. Suppose this is 7.7, return 7%. And suppose there are various classes are there, like class SBI. So class SBI can override this method. Class SBI extends bank. Similarly, class PNB extends bank. and there is another class, class UCO bank. Suppose UCO extends bank. So there are three banks are there. So is bank is any entity, real world entity? If I call you, just go to the bank. So basically, you may ask me that which bank actually. Fine. Bank is a very generalized term. Okay. So here, अगर आपसे कोई पूछता है कि what is the interest of bank? So first thing you ask, which bank actually? Because different bank is having different interest. It means, is there any significance of this method definition here? Get interest 7. Is there any meaning here? Because कोई एक बैंक का तो कोई इंटरेस्ट होता नहीं, हर एक स्पेसिफिक बैंक के इंटरेस्ट होते हैं ना. तो देयर इज नो मीनिंग ऑफ डेफिनेशन हियर, बिकॉज इफ एनी बैंक एक्सटेंड्स दिस बैंक क्लास, तो दैट पर्टिकुलर सब क्लास नीड्स टू ओवरराइड इट. तो अगर ओवरराइड करना ही है तो यहाँ डेफिनेशन देने की जरूरत है. इज देयर एनी रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ डेफिनेशन हियर? नो. तो आप कहोगे नहीं सर, अगर कोई बैंक नहीं ओवरराइड करता है तो मान लेंगे 7 है, तो ऐसा तो होगा नहीं. हर बैंक अपना अलग अलग हिसाब से करेगा. तो इन देयर बेसिकली इन सम क्लासेस द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इज लीव टू इट्स सब क्लासेस. ओके, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इज लीव टू इट्स सब क्लासेस. ओके, सो हियर जस्ट लीव द डेफिनेशन पार्ट, मीन्स इम्प्लीमेंटेशन डिटेल. एंड नाउ एसबीआई कैन Override this get interest method as according to its need. Similarly, UCO Bank can override it and PNB can override it. Okay. Now, so here, so as per the definition here, if you make, yeah, if you create a method where the implementation detail is not required. Okay, implementation is left to its subclasses. In that particular case, you need to make that method as abstract method. एक तरीके का टेम्पलेट प्रोवाइड करता है अपनी चाइल्ड क्लासेस को, कि हमने आपको एक टेम्पलेट दे दिया, आप अपने अपने अकॉर्डिंग उसको यूज कर लो. जस्ट आई गिव यू ए टेम्पलेट. ओके, हियर तो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मैथड इज means it the implementation detail is not mentioned. Okay, implementation detail is not mentioned here, and the child classes can implement it according to its need. Okay, now and if you make any method as abstract method, then you need to make the class as abstract also. अगर किसी भी क्लास में कोई भी एक मेथड ऐसा होगा जिसकी डेफिनेशन मीन्स अब्स्ट्रैक्ट है वो मेथड, तो यू नीड टू मेक दैट पर्टिकुलर क्लास एज अब्स्ट्रैक्ट. ओके, एन अब्स्ट्रैक्ट इज ए कीवर्ड. तो जस्ट क्रिएट ए अब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास लाइक दिस, अब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास बैंक. ओके, एब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास बैंक. तो यू नीड टू राइट द क्लास लाइक दिस. ओके, एंड मेथड नेम इज लाइक पब्लिक इंटीजर कैलकुलेट, सॉरी पब्लिक एब्स्ट्रैक्ट इंटीजर, पब्लिक एब्स्ट्रैक्ट इंटीजर कैलकुलेट एन इंटीजर एक्स सपोज. ओके, ये इंटीजर एक्स इसको भी छोड़ देते हैं. सपोज दिस इज द कैलकुलेट मेथड, यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस, पब्लिक एब्स्ट्रैक्ट इंटीजर कैलकुलेट. इफ यू राइट द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट, यू नीड टू पुट हियर द सेमी कॉलन. यू नीड नॉट टू राइट द ओपनिंग ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ब्रेसेस ऑल्सो, बिकॉज द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन डिटेल इज नॉट देयर. ओके अगर आपने ओपनिंग और क्लोजिंग ब्रेसेस लिख लिया तो इसका मतलब एक तरीके का वो मेथड हो गया, भले उसके अंदर कोई डिटेल नहीं है, आपको यहाँ पर सेमी कॉलन के बाद टर्मिनेट करना पड़ेगा इस मेथड को। सो यू नीड टू राइट लाइक दिस, मीन्स यू नीड टू राइट एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कीवर्ड बिफोर द मेथड ऑल्सो। ओके एंड इफ यू क्रिएट द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड तो इन द चाइल्ड क्लास यू नीड टू इम्प्लीमेंट द डेफिनेशन, और यू कैन से दैट यू नीड टू ओवरराइड इट। ओके आई जस्ट क्रिएट ए प्रोग्राम, विद द हेल्प ऑफ प्रोग्राम वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट। एब्स्ट्रैक्शन का प्रोग्राम ही बना लेते हैं।
Sir, your screen is not visible.
Okay. I think now it is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I just take the example of each case study in bank class. Okay, here I just create a class bank, and in bank class I create a get interest method, get interest method, and I make this method as abstract in nature with the help of abstract keyword. And if I make any method as abstract in a class, so we need to make that particular class as abstract. Okay? We need to make that particular class as abstract. And now, you can make different child classes that override its get interest method as per the need of child class. Like if I write SBI extends bank, here SBI class implements the abstract method integer get interest return suppose 7. Okay, now I just create another class PNB. I just copy this class, I just change the name of class only. So in place of SBI I just write PNB, and suppose the rate of interest is 8. So there are two classes, SBI and PNB, fine. And suppose one more class, UCO Bank, suppose. And UCO Bank will return 9%, suppose. Okay. Now, if you would like to invoke this get interest method of SBI class, so you need to create the object of SBI. If you would like to invoke the get interest method of PNB, then you need to invoke PNB object, means you need to invoke the object, means method of get interest with the help of PNB object, similarly for UCO. Now, if you, in this case, here you can see that the method implementation is not there in the case of abstract class. It means you will not be able to create the object of this bank class. Why? Because method implementation is not there. So here at the time of object creation, So how much memory is required? It is not known. How much the memory is required? It is not known. So actually you cannot create the object of bank class. Here bank class is just like, means this is abstract class is just, suppose you may ask the question that sir, is there is no any concrete method is there, so what is the need of the creation of object here? अगर आप इसका कोई कॉन्क्रीट मेथड है ही नहीं तो जरूरत भी क्या है ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट करने की. तो जस्ट आई क्रिएट अ कॉन्क्रीट मेथड हियर आल्सो, सपोज वाइड. सो I can write this. What is this? This is concrete method. Concrete method means the definition is there. So in this abstract class, there are two methods. One is get interest, that is abstract. Another one is concrete method, so method. So in SBI, which extends the bank class, overrides this get interest method and inherits the so method. But in order to call this so method, you cannot access the so method with the help of bank class object. You cannot create the bank class object. Means if you write bank class object here, means in this public static void main, suppose if I would like to write bank p equal to new bank, so there is a problem. Okay. In here you can see that there are two things. Is one is the reference variable, another one is the object. With the help of this line, an object is created that is referred by this B. You can say that here the reference variable is of type bank and the object type is also bank. But error kahan aa rahi hai? Error is in object type. Means object, you cannot create the object. But here you can see you cannot create the object, but you can create the reference type of bank. You can create the bank type of ref, means you can create the reference of type bank, but you cannot create the object of bank. Okay, now so here if I write in place of bank, if I write SBI, then it is okay, because SBI is the child class of bank class. Now we can refer SBI object with the help of bank class of type of reference type of bank. Reference type bank. Okay, if you write this, so with the help of B, you can actually access get interest method of which class? SBI class. इसको देखो किधर लगेगा. वो हो रहा है क्या? ओके, थैंक यू. ओके, सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट यू कैन क्रिएट द रेफरेंस ऑफ टाइप बैंक, बट यू कैन नॉट क्रिएट द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ बैंक. So if you write b dot get interest, so actually which particular method is called? Actually this is the example of polymorphism. Here also you if you call the get interest method, so actually the definition of get interest of SBI, okay, is called. Similarly if you write like this, bank b equal to new bank b equal to new pnb देन बी वन सेम हो गया, तो बी वन बैंक बी वन इक्वल टू न्यू पीएनबी, तो विद द हेल्प ऑफ बी वन यू विल बी एबल टू कॉल द गेट इंटरेस्ट मेथड ऑफ पीएनबी. ओके fine, and basically so method can be called by b1 as well as b or not kiya ja sakta hai ki nahi kiya sakta so method can be called or not by b or b1. No, why किया जा सकता है? देखो अगर आप लिखते हो बी डॉट तो गेट एंड सो, इफ यू कॉल दिस सो पर्टिकुलर मेथड, तो एक्चुअली विच पर्टिकुलर मेथड इज कॉल्ड हियर? द मेथड विच इज इनहेरिटेड बाय द सब क्लास. ओके नाउ it means if you would like to call the so method, actually you need to create the object of child class, fine, and means because if this particular class is abstract in nature, so you cannot access the so method with the help of bank object. Okay, you cannot access the with the help of bank object because we cannot create the object of bank class because this is abstract in nature, fine. Okay, now the thing is which particular approach is better in place of bank. ye hum bank kar kyun rahe hain, in place of bank I can write here SBI and I can write here PNB, fine. So is there any difference or not? कोई अंतर आया? No. By get interest method of PNB is called, get interest method of SBI is called. So is there any significance of creating the reference type as bank? Is there any significance of creating the reference type as bank? अगर कोई सिग्निफिकेंस नहीं है तब तो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास रेफरेंस टाइप क्रिएट कर सकती है, इसका सिग्निफिकेंस खत्म हो जाएगा ना. मींस एब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास यू कैन नॉट क्रिएट द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास बट यू कैन क्रिएट द रेफरेंस वेरिएबल ऑफ टाइप ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास. तो इन दिस केस देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम, बट इफ यू क्रिएट इफ यू राइट हियर बैंक एंड बैंक, तो व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ इट? कैन एनीवन टेल? स्पेलिंग में मिस्टेक है क्या बैंक? हाँ, व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ इट? कोई बताए? ओके सपोज देयर आर 10 टाइप्स ऑफ बैंक्स आर देयर, सपोज देयर आर 10 types of banks of there, and you need to create a method in order to find out the name of bank which is having high rate of interest, yeah, which is having maximum rate of interest. ye aapko pata karna hai. If there are 10 types of bank, basically in this example there are 3 banks, so I just write here, means I just create the 3 objects. Suppose bank B2 equal to new UCO. There are 3 objects that is referred by B, B1 and B2, and if you would like to find out the name of bank which is having the maximum rate of interest, so how can you find that? So basically name of bank pata karna hai to aapko ek method likhna padega, kya? Get name. So if I create here a variable string name. So that is inherited here, and here there is a method string get name. Suppose okay. Here, in order to set the value of set name, you need to name set the name like a string name. This dot name equal to name. Okay. एक फील्ड तो देनी पड़ेगी अगर नेम पता करना है तो. ओके, तो दिस इज द सेट नेम. विद द हेल्प ऑफ सेट नेम यू कैन फाइंड आउट द नेम ऑफ, यू कैन फाइंड आउट, यू कैन सेट द नेम हियर. सिमिलरली यू जस्ट राइट दिस, कॉपी दिस मेथड टू ऑल क्लासेस. कट जस्ट कॉपी इट. Now, suppose if you would like to create a method which can find out the maximum rate of interest, means name of bank which is having maximum rate of interest, how can you define that particular method? That method should return the name of bank. So return type should be string. Fine, return type should be string. तो वो method रखा कहाँ पर जाए? Definition कहाँ रखी जाए उसकी? इसी में रख लेते हैं मेन वाले में. कहाँ रखें डेफिनेशन? वेयर वी नीड टू राइट द मेथड व्हिच टेक्स ऑल द बैंक ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट दैट द नेम ऑफ बैंक व्हिच इज हैविंग द मैक्सिमम रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. Okay, if I just write here a method like that will return a string maximum rate of interest, suppose maximum rate of interest. Okay, now suppose this is the method from where I need to call it. Actually we need to call it here from the main method. I need to call it from the main method, maximum rate method. Okay, see. So how can I call the maximum rate method without creating the object? So basically, we need to create this method as static in nature. अगर हम इस तरीके से static बना लेते हैं, तो we can just directly call it this particular method. And actually, within the static method, we can call the static method directly within the static context. And now. एक्चुअली मैक्सिमम रेट अगर हमको पता करना है तो एक्चुअली व्हाट आर द आर्गुमेंट्स वी नीड टू पास हियर, विच टाइप ऑफ आर्गुमेंट वी नीड टू पास हियर. क्या पास करना पड़ेगा? तीन ऑब्जेक्ट है मेरे पास, ठीक है, तो एक एरे पास कर सकते हैं ऑब्जेक्ट्स की, और उस एरे से हम पता कर सकते हैं कि एक्चुअली कौन से ऑब्जेक्ट का गेट रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट सबसे ज्यादा है. वी कैन पास हियर द पास एन एरे ऑफ, एरे ऑफ विच टाइप? एसबीआई टाइप, यूको टाइप और पीएनबी टाइप. तो तीनों के ऑब्जेक्ट पास कर सकें उस मेथड में, तो हमको एक जनरलाइज्ड टाइप रखना पड़ेगा जो तीनों के ऑब्जेक्ट्स को अपने इसको रेफर कर सके. इन दैट पर्टिकुलर केस वी नीड टू क्रिएट एन एरे ऑफ सुपर क्लास टाइप. So in this case, abstract class type. Okay. So here I need to write like this, bank, suppose B, this. Now this bank can take any type of object. So here, just create, if I just create an array, just create an array of bank type. Ek array create kar lete hain. How can I create array of bank B? New. Okay. And here, the first B0 refer to SBI object, and then B1 refer to PNB object, and then B2 refer to UCO object. Okay, and now I just comment this line because there is no significance of this here. I just comment this. Okay, so I need to pass the array B here. Sorry, I need to pass the array B here. Here you can see that I just passed the array B in this, and now you can write the definition. You can write the definition here. In this string, maximum rate. How can you find out the maximum rate? Because now you are having an array, and now you can traverse the array and try to find out the object which is having maximum rate of interest. Okay. So this concept is called as polymorphic array. Polymorphic array as a parameter. Okay. So this is the significance why we need to create the reference type of bank. Means you can create the reference type of bank class, fine, but you cannot create the object of this bank class. So this is the significance of creating reference type of bank class. Now, so there are certain other cases also. There are certain another important rules here. Now, suppose in this abstract class, there are two abstract methods. Okay, if in this abstract class, there are two abstract methods. One abstract method is like this, abstract. Suppose integer m. If I create another abstract method m. So in the child class SBI, if there are two abstract methods, so it is mandatory for child class. The child class should implement or override all the abstract method of its parent class. क्योंकि अगर दो abstract method parent class में है तो child class के पास दोनों एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड आ तो जाएंगे, दोनों को इंप्लीमेंट ओवरराइड करना पड़ेगा. इफ चाइल्ड क्लास लीव दिस एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड एम हियर, सो देन देयर इज एन एरर इज जनरेटेड. मींस चाइल्ड क्लास नीड्स टू ओवरराइड ऑल द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड. अगर आपने इसको ओवरराइड नहीं किया तो फिर वही प्रॉब्लम आएगी कि मेमोरी डिफाइंड नहीं हो पाएगी और ऑब्जेक्ट नहीं क्रिएट हो पाएगा. सो इन फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर केस यू नीड टू मेक दिस क्लास एज एब्स्ट्रैक्ट. Then the error is removed. Means child class भी abstract हो गई, क्योंकि उसके अंदर भी एक abstract method आ गया ना, उसकी definition तो हुई नहीं, because child class inherits the parent class. If there are two abstract methods is there, so in this case child SBI inherits the get interest, but get interest is overridden here, but m is not overridden here. So here you need to make child class as abstract in nature. And इसको रिमूव कैसे करेंगे? You can remove this by just implementing the abstract method like this, integer m. Just if I write this, set the definition here, return something, suppose return 0. Okay. So if I write the definition here, then you can remove this abstract keyword. Then there is no problem. But in the case of PNB, again, the error is there because PNB also extends the bank class. And bank class is having one abstract method which is not implemented here. So either you need to implement all the abstract method of its superclass or either make this subclass as abstract in nature. So abstraction child class mein tab tak bana rahega jab tak sare abstract method implement nahi ho jate hain. Ho sakta ho jaise humne likha tha na employee secretary legal secretary there are multiple hierarchy of inheritance tab tak chalta rahega jab tak sare method implement nahi ho jayenge kyunki जब तक इंप्लीमेंट नहीं हो जाएंगे तब तक आप ऑब्जेक्ट नहीं क्रिएट कर पाओगे. अब यहाँ पर एसबीआई जब एब्स्ट्रैक्ट तो एसबीआई का भी ऑब्जेक्ट नहीं क्रिएट हो पाता, फिर इसकी चाइल्ड क्लास आपको बनानी पड़ती और जो एक बचा हुआ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड उसको इंप्लीमेंट करना होता, ओवरराइड करना होता, तब चाइल्ड क्लास का आप ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट करते. ओके, तो दिस इज द केस. तो देर आर सर्टन अनदर रूल्स रिलेटेड टू एब्स्ट्रैक्ट, वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट टर्न. देर आर सर्टन स्पेसिफिक रूल्स फॉर द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास. ओके, abstraction is not over here. We need to discuss some more concept related to the abstract class, and after that there is one more concept in Java programming, that is interface. So with the help of interface we can also achieve the abstraction. Okay, so there are two ways, one is abstract class, another one is interface. Okay, so we will see the interface and abstract class points. There are some points are there in abstract class, we will discuss in the next one. Okay.